Anyways, neither of these two gentlemen have been wearing a hat today. Ben and Lightning Cam.
Two hatless individuals.
Please, I was about to say, please give me something, dude. I'm not. Don't just let me segue and then just leave me hanging.
I thought you had something going. I really had a lot of faith
oh
in you.
Oh, my God, no. So have you heard
speed.
My transitions?
Okay, Ben immediately went for speed, and I wasn't ready for it. There was a lot that I was not ready for right now.
He often will go for speed right off the bat. Ben is one of those short players that is so good at pressing buttons.
Yeah. Going up against Lightning Cam, this is going to be a hard thing. If he's able to actively, like, properly utilize his Monado Arts and make it difficult for Diddy to deal with speed or jump or, you know, the damage of Buster and the spacing, then he can definitely use... Oh, look at that.
Yeah.
That was really good.
Like I said, he's so good at pressing buttons. Like, he's very in tune with this character. It's just a matter of whether his game plans are going to work in any given match he's playing.
The thing is, I think Diddy is a really good character to actually deal with air-to-air Shulk. He'll be able to put out a fair faster than Shulk can come down in space and air or fair because Shulk has a lot of startup on those moves. Really good switch to shield.
Yeah, no, he's been on point with that so far. But again, like you said, Diddy Kong is good at locking down Shulk whenever he's in the air, and that means that Ben's going to have to play a much more patient game, which he is not used to doing, but look at that right there. You don't need to be patient if your edge guarding looks like that.
Yeah, that was a really good air slash. Dropping down, positioning himself perfectly. Nice empty hop into the grab. You have a little bit lower of an empty hop with that speed art, so it becomes a much more volatile mix-up. You know, fast followers are really good at going for empty landing mix-ups. Floating characters
harder
usually
to react
not.
To.
Yeah.
Also has to do with your jump height as well. Nice drift back there by Ben to make sure he doesn't hit that banana. Yeah, good awareness. I think that when it comes to anything other than, like, actively, like, mixing up game plans while he's playing, Ben is really good at this game.
Ooh, yeah.
I gotta see, though, Lightning Cam, though, is so consistent with these setups. He never has trouble taking out a stock, I feel like, and that's one of the things that is really gonna help him against Shulk, who really thrives on that struggle.
And great spacing on the very edge of that neutral air, too. He's got the damage with a buster, but he doesn't want this yet. Yeah, drop out of the buster, because he wants to get this kill. I mean, he's at 86, but you know, Shulk will always be fiending.
Especially if he can, you know, get that smash art back online. Ben can kind of hold back a little bit, wait for the smash art, or catch that monkey flip back onto the stage, which Cam is want to do.
That up air is really strong. I know in 4 it was like literally the just top 3 strongest up airs in the game.
It's still got to be up there, man, because we've seen some early stocks out of that. And look at all that damage just off of one air slash. Buster, once you go up a stock, you like to switch into Buster really quickly as Shulk and see what you can get.
Like, I'm going to take less knockback. I'm also going to do more damage, especially when you're a high percent. It's like low risk kind of.
Oh! Ben really had a great mix up there with the movement, but he just misspaced himself. Oh my goodness, the switch to Smash. Ah!
I'm scared. Smash is almost out. Yeah, there he goes. Buster gets good damage. Down throw forward till looks like a low percent.
Nice! Great aerial waiting by Ben right there. The patience has been nice.
Trying to air slash to cover the roll behind, but that up tilt covering a little bit faster.
Oh my goodness. And here's the thing, Ben will constantly try to switch up the Monado Arts, keep you on your toes, and you don't often see him just like totally naked like this. Not, of course, the skin, but running no Monado Arts. Oh my goodness, and he tried to go for the same edge guard right there, and that time it worked out for Cam because he was far enough underneath the stage that barrels did instantly put Ben in a tech situation.
Yeah, they blew up. They didn't blow up on him last time, but this time they did blow up.
Because Cam wasn't so far directly under the stage that the barrels hit it.
Oh, I
see.
And that time,
Cam was a little bit further under the stage. Whether or not it was on purpose, it meant that Ben had the technology on the stage, and he did not.
Yeah. Unfortunately, and Ben was ahead by a lot. He actually didn't have to go down there for that edge guard. Of course, it would have clearly taken the stock, and it worked earlier in the set, or in the game. Who would have thought that it would go so sour? But unfortunately for Ben, Cam coming out on top there.
Yeah, barrels are volatile, man. You have to treat them with respect sometimes. I mean, again, when you get Diddy Kong out off the stage, I mean, that's where Shulk is going to get a lot of the edge guards. But up close to the stage, you have to respect what that move can do.
Oh my goodness, you got to respect those barrels. Sometimes he just comes barreling at you, and it's not a good time.
Well, there we go. That neutral air. Look at all this damage Ben is doing just by ledge trapping Cam. That's what Buster Art's made for. Ooh. I love that movement in there. I think Smash Art may have helped him fall out of that,
yeah,
to be honest.
I have no idea. I mean, sometimes that's just not a consistent thing. Oh, he teched. That was so good.
This time, the technology from Cam.
He did have the technology. Again. Just barrel at him. Just throw the barrels at him.
That is
Diddy
the lightning
Kong has kill. Three projectiles. the banana, the peanuts, and himself with barrels attached.
And speaking of projectiles, Shulk is looking like some live ammo right now with how quickly he got into that blast zone. And now, with that smash arc, even it right up and get ready to launch into that speed Monado art, which is so good when your opponent's on the Angel Plat because you can just run away from him.
Really, really phenomenal spacing on that back air. Just the tip. Okay, this could be big damage.
I like that by Ben. He was getting those Monado arts ready on the wheel in case Cam chased him down, but the moment he didn't, he realized, okay, I might be able to get something off of the Buster now. He didn't, but it was really good of reaction and awareness, like, in the moment.
Dash attack to the up air. Swapping to speed.
That'll help him get down quicker. Like you said, you get that extra fast falling when you're in that speed art, and Ben will get back down to the stage quicker with that active.
It's very true. Using the air slash to cover the cross-up option.
Ooh, that was a great bait there by Cam. He threw out that banana and then wanted Ben to go up to it and get anything off it. Forward throw will do it.
No, just barely not. I thought it was Smash Art, perhaps. But they weren't very close to the edge of the stage, maybe three-fourths of the way.
As I apologize that no sounded like Principal Skinner from the Steve Ham skit.
Oh, no.
That was so completely unintentional. Nice wait there by Ben.
He was definitely scouting it.
Mm-hmm. Not able to take the stock, though, and at 156, yeah, why not go for the Buster, man? I mean, you're not going to... You're not going to live if something like that happens, but honestly, you go, hey, I've got to pull down this damage to even this game back up.
Buster at low percents for Shulk is kind of scary because, yeah, you can put on a little bit more damage, but if you're at low percent and you get hit by a combo, you can take up so much.
Your opponent's combo game becomes all that much more potent, and Ben looking for another one of those potent Smash Art air slashes. He's running up to him and shielding because he wants Cam to attack that shield and then get an air slash out of shield.
Yeah. Finds an air slash out of shield there, but no Smash Art active again.
Nice coverage, yeah. Wait. Unfortunately, Cam was ready for him to wait for that banana to land and then do the up tilt on that specific tempo.
Wow, he wasn't ready to punish those barrels on shield. Ooh, a little bit stuck in the wheel.
Ooh, now. Could be a bad situation for Ben. He noticed, he wanted to respect that down smash on the shield because Shulk out of shield doesn't have the best options outside of the air slash. And right there, again, that aerial game is where he strives.
Ooh, late hit, back hit in there. It's a little conversion. Short hop air dodge. I don't know if that's what he wanted. Relieved all the pressure.
Perfectly timed with that down tilt as Cam was going for those barrels. Oh, that board smash would have done a ton of damage, too. There we go. Quick switches on those Monado arts. We've seen it time and time again from Ben.
That wheel in the sky keeps on turning. And I don't know where I'll be tomorrow.
And this is what song?
It's The Wheels in the Sky by Journey.
Okay.
It's a really good song.
I believe you. Journey has a lot of good songs. My goodness, that narrow.
It looks like Ben is going to be on a journey to the blast zone.
Well,
Cam taking it to 2-0.
Yeah, 2-0 for Cam, you know. And that doesn't surprise me fully. I mean, that's a pretty even matchup between those two players as far as, like, skill level is concerned.
Yeah.
But Cam, for a while, both in this game and in Smash 4, has played Shulk. He has, like, a secondary Shulk.
He does